In this video, we'll discuss about the Brasenham's line and drawing algorithm. So, why exactly we need Brasenham's line drawing algorithm? How do we implement this Brasenham's line drawing algorithm? And we'll try to understand how it works and what is the need of such algorithms. So, to begin with, so let's take an example of few line segments are given over here. So you can see that, see there are different ways, forms of line. So you can see one line which is has the end coordinates at 2,6 and 2,14. So now if you look at this line, so what happens is when we draw the line, it is nothing but in computer graphics, we assume that we are going to plot the pixels. So these pixels are getting stored in the frame buffer. This you might be knowing, you might have already learned this, right? So I'll start plotting the pixel from the given location. So how do I start? So I know that then one endpoint of the line is at 2,6. I start plotting the pixel at 2,6. Okay. So I move ahead. So when we move ahead, what is happening? So the next location of the pixel. So if you observe, both the endpoints says that x will remain at 2 only, right? There is no change in x. We start at 2,x. The other endpoint ends at 2,14. So no change in x. Which is why gets clearly incremented by 1. So if it is 2,6 here, the next pixel is at 2,7, 2,8, 2,9 and so on, and we finally reach 2,14. So that's end of the line. So here we don't have any problem. Why we don't have any problem is x remains constant and y is getting incremented by 1. Okay, so as in this case, say the second case, if I take, we have 10,8 and 20,8, just have these coordinates I've just given for reference only, it may not be exactly 20,8. Okay, so I start from 10,8, and if I observe here 10,8 and 20,8, in both the endpoints y is constant, that is it is 8 only. So when I move from one pixel to the other, what happens is x is clearly getting incremented by 1. So if I start 10,8, next pixel is 11,8, 12,8, 13,8 and so on, it continues up to what, 20,8. So there is no problem with these two cases of the line. Now when we go to the other cases, but this may not be always the case. So I'm giving one example here where we have 1,18 and 15,25. That means one endpoint is 1,18, the other one is at 15,25, somewhere like that. Okay. So I start plotting the pixel at 1,18, right? So I start the pixel at 1,18. So what should be the next location? So what has happened here, if you see in this diagram, x is getting incremented by 1. So we get what? 2, so why didn't change? If you observe this pixel, see 1,18, next is 2,18 itself, right? I go to the next location. So here our line is passing through this pixel. So what is the possibility here? It is x was 1 here, 2 here. So this pixel will be 3, right? But we started at 18 over here. So what is this? So one pixel above 18. So it is 19. Now if you look into this one change we have observed, what is the change? See, in these two cases, we didn't have any problem. Blindly, we could have incremented either x by 1 or y by 1. But in this case, it's not happening so. See here, what is happening? We incremented x by 1, kept y constant. Here we incremented both x by 1 and y, 1. Here also we are incrementing both x and y, 1. And so on. See, some cases what is happening? X is getting incremented by 1, y is also getting incremented by 1. But in some cases, only x got incremented here, whereas y continues to be the same as the previous pixel. Now the problem arises here. So how do we decide which pixel to be chosen? So I have option for this as what, whether I have to increment both x and y, or should we increment only x keeping y constant. Okay. So let us take another example here. I have 10, 18 and 20, 20. Again, I am telling you, I've just taken the coordinates only for reference, it may not be the exact measurements. Okay. So I started at 10,18. So the line is again swept through 11,18. So x got incremented, y remained constant. Then I went to 12, 18, 13, 18, 14, 18. So what has happened again in this case? X continuously kept incremented, but y is still constant. So when we reached here, somewhere it got increased by 1 or so, something like that has happened, right? So what is happening here is, in some cases what we have is, we have an ambiguity to take a decision about the pixel location. So what is that ambiguity? Always there will be two contenders, so two neighboring pixels will be generally the contenders. So we have to make an intelligent decision between these two pixels, like which has to be chosen, right? So what are those? So in some cases what will happen is, either x gets incremented by 1 continuously, while y we will have a doubt whether to increment it or whether to keep it constant. Similarly, in some cases it might get other way around. What happens is, y might get continuously incremented by 1, but x may continue to share, say in this case x might remain same in some cases. For two pixels, x might be one and the same, but y is getting incremented continuously. So in such cases, we have to make an intelligent decision, like how do we choose the pixels. Okay, so to solve these issues, actually we are having line drawing algorithms. So one such algorithm is Bresnahan's line drawing algorithm. So basically, in Bresnahan's line drawing algorithm, what happens is, it will tell us, whenever we have a competition between two pixels, which pixel has to be chosen. Okay, this is what is the use of what? Bresnahan's line drawing algorithm. So I think you're clear, like why we are using Bresnahan's line drawing algorithm. Okay. So now, how did Bresnahan solve these issues? Okay. So he introduced a very simple concept. He said we can use a decision variable. So this, based on the value of the decision variable, we'll take a decision whether we are among the two contending pixels, which pixels is more accurate for us to plot the line. Okay, so it's simple algorithm, we'll just have a look at it. So as I told you, in the line is actually straight, that is either horizontal line or a vertical line, we'll not have any problem. The problem arises only if the lines are slanting. So instead of telling slanting lines, we can tell in terms of slopes. The slopes of the line are what? Non-zero values. It could be greater than 1, it could be less than 1. Okay, so in these two cases, slope is 0, that means they are horizontal or either vertical lines. We don't have to worry about the pixels, it will be continuous. But if the slope is non-zero value, either positive 1, negative 1, or like it can be 0.9 or any other value, basically not 0, then we will have to make an intelligent decision. So to solve this, we will be using Bresnahan's line drawing algorithm. So let's see how we will use this. So first and foremost, as I mentioned in the previous diagram, to form a line, we need two end segments. Read the two end points of the line. So assume that we will draw the first endpoint in x1, y1 and the second endpoint in x2, y2. That is two endpoints. So basically, if you go up and see, so in x1, y1, maybe I will store 1, 18, and then next x2, y2, I will store 15, 25, something like that. Okay. So once we read the values and store them in x1, y1 and x2, y2, any variable you can choose, but I have chosen x1, y1, x2, y2. We will compute dx and dy. What is dx and dy? That is difference between the x coordinate and difference between the y coordinate. How do we compute that? Dx is basically computed as what? x2 minus x1 and dy is computed as what? y2 minus y1. So this is simple, just compute the value of what? x2 minus x1 and y2 minus y1, store it in two variables, dx and dy. Once we get these two values, we'll get one important thing. What is that important thing is, if the compare these two values, that is among dx and dy, which is greater. And I suppose if dx is greater than dy, then we call x is deriving axis. Now what do you mean by deriving axis? Okay, I'll just go back to the slide. See, if What it means by deriving axis deriving axis means we can observe that when the axis deriving axis x will continuously get incremented by 1, okay, x gets continuously incremented by 1, but the y value we are not sure. That means y might be same as the previous pixel, or some cases it might get incremented by 1 in each step. So if you understand that x is deriving axis, we can be clear that x always gets incremented by 1. Okay. So when is this case? That is, if dx is greater than dy, then we say deriving axis x axis. Now, what if it is not? That means dx is not greater than dy. Obviously, dy is greater. What do you mean by dy is greater? Then deriving axis is y axis. So, what can we understand if deriving axis is y axis? It means that y will always get incremented by 1 for such lines. That is, if the line is having dy is greater than dx, that means y will always get incremented by 1. But the value of x, we can't assure that it always gets incremented by 1. That means some cases x might continue to be the same as the previous pixel, and some cases it might get incremented by 1. Now, from this you can also understand the concept of slope. So slope is calculated by using m is equal to dy by dx. That is how we calculate the slope. So if dx is greater, obviously what happens, the slope will be less than 0, right? Like dx is greater, so we are having dx in the denominator, so the slope will what? Will get less than 0. Otherwise it will be greater than 1. That is how it will be. So sometimes we use it slope values also. So that's why I just told you like what is the meaning of this. Okay. So if you have understood so much what is deriving axis, I hope I am clear with it. So I have mentioned here again, the deriving axis is x axis and dx is positive. That means always x gets incremented by 1. Okay. What if x is negative, dx is negative, then x increment is minus 1. What do you understand by dx is negative? Now, so for example, if I give the coordinates in the other way around, so some people might want to draw the line from 20, 20 to 10, 18, like this, from this to this point. Then what happens? This is my x1, y1, this is my x2, y2. So x1 is 20, x1 is 20, x2 is 10. So when I calculate dx, what it will be? 10 minus 20. So will I get a negative number? That means I need to come in the reverse direction by decrementing x. What is the meaning of that? I start from 20, next pixel will be 19, next will be 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, so on, and finally I reach 10. That means I am going back. So such cases of the line we'll have dx is negative. So if dx is negative, instead of going from 20 to somewhere else, we have to what? Come down. That is what is the meaning, right? So that is what this point tells us. If dx is positive, x increments by 1, otherwise x decrements by 1. In the same way, once we find this, if dy is positive, then x gets incremented by 1. Dy is positive, y gets incremented by 1. If it is negative, it is decremented by 1. So, quickly, if we have to understand what we did, we get the endpoints x1, y1, x2, y2. Compute the differences, that is, dx is x2 minus x1, dy y2 minus y1. Then find out which is the deriving axis, that means whichever is greater is deriving axis. So, deriving axis means that value, that axis value will always get incremented by 1. The other axis value we need to have compute and find out what is the right value for that. Okay. Now, okay. So here we have some formulas. This is these formulas were actually introduced by Bresenems. So this is how he told how we can make a decision between the two neighboring pixels using decision variable. So these are basically the formulas for decision variables. So I will explain this with an example. I think that will be much clearer instead of writing this. Okay. So I've written here the formulas. So in the previous case, I've told you how do we determine deriving axis. Okay. So if deriving axis is x-axis, we use this decision variable formulas written like this. Pk is any value you can take, but I've taken decision variable as pk because standard textbooks they have used this notation. That's why I kept it as it is. Okay. So 2 into dy minus dx. So this is called as initial decision variable value. What do you mean by the initial decision variable value? This variable value will be using only once in one iteration. So for the initial decision, later on this formula will get changed. Now if you look into this table clearly, I told deriving axis is x axis. What does it mean? Dx is greater than dy. Once we get that, we calculate the decision variable value as 2 into dy minus dx. We will get some value over here. We know dy, we know dx. When we substitute this, we will get a value for pk. So let us assume we are having dy as 4 and dx as 6. Let us assume like that, okay. So because deriving axis is x, obviously dx should be greater. That's why I took this value. So 2 into 4 will make us what? 8. And dx was 6. So 8 minus 6. What did we get the pk value? 2. Right? So decision variable is 2. Now based on this pk value, we will take a decision. What is that? If p naught is less than 0, x is x plus 1, y is y. What do you understand by this? As I told, decision deriving axis is x. X will always get incremented by 1, no doubt about it. But what about the value of y? Either we should keep as it is as a previous value or we should increment. So what does it tell? If p naught is less than 0, don't change the value of y, continue the previous y value itself. What if it is greater than or equal to 0? Just increment y by 1. What about the x value here? Obviously, it should get incremented by, no doubt, because deriving x is x, right? Okay. So, once we get this pk value, we got this value, okay? For the next iteration, the pk formula will slightly change. What is that? Okay. Now, we got pk. So, according to the value what I given, we got pk as 2. So, whether it is less than 0? No, it is not less than 0. It is greater than 0. If it is greater than 0, so the next iteration pk value will be calculated using this formula. What is that? The same as this, but add the previous pk value. That's it. Right? So, what if in the first iteration itself we got pk as less than 0? Then we have to use this formula to find the decision variable. That's all. Now, if you observe, if you remember this one formula, you can write the other formulas very easily. What is that? Very easily how you can write is, see, 2 into dx minus dy. See, if the deriving axis is x, we have this formula. If the deriving axis is y, we just interchange the positions of x and y. That's all. Okay, you can write it anywhere. Okay, so I will explain you again with the examples how to use this formulas, and I think it will be much clearer for you all. Okay, so actually there can be 6 cases for the line, okay, that we will see here, all the 6 cases. So first case, as I've already told you, in this case what has happened, if you observe here, x1 is 2, x2 is also 2, we did not change the position of x, so what will be dx value? 0. So do we have any problem in plotting the pixels? No, no doubt. X is always same, but y always gets incremented by 1. So we don't have to use any decision variable concept here. Keep incrementing, whichever is 0, if dx is 0, that indicates what, x is same. We don't have to make any change, but y keep on incrementing. Case 2. What do you mean by case 2? Dy is 0. What is on dy is 0? That means y is not changing, x keeps changing by 1. So again, we don't need the help of decision variable. It's quite clear. Now, next, move on to the next case. So case 3. So I've taken a case where slope is positive and it is greater than 1. Okay. So in other way around, we'll just check out how to solve this using Bresenham's line drawing algorithm. So, I have taken x1 coordinate is 10, 10, and x2, y2 coordinate is at what? 12, 15. So, x is 12, y is 15. Now, what is the first step to solve Bresenham's line drawing algorithm? I told you, compute dx and dy. Actually, it is called delta x and delta y. So, in programming, instead of delta x, delta y, we use dx, dy. So, that's why I have used some cases, I have used dx. So, you can use handwritten, so I thought of writing dx, okay, delta x, sorry. So, you can use dx here, no problem, okay, delta x is same as dx. So I computed delta x as what? X2 minus x1. So what we get? 12 minus 10 is 2. Then I calculate the value of delta y or dy. What is it? Y2 minus y1. 15 minus 10 is 5. Now among these two, which is greater? Dy is greater than dx. What do you understand when dy is greater than dx? Deriving axis is y-axis. What do you understand by this? We'll clearly understand by this. So we know the first location of the pixel. What is that? 10 comma 10. What else we know? We know where to end. Where to end? It is already given, x2, y2. Because to draw the line, two endpoints are essential. From where to where? Those endpoints are given to us. 12 comma 15. So fill these two. 10, 10, 12, 15 you fill. Done. What is deriving axis here? Y-axis. What did I tell? Said y will always get incremented by 1 if the deriving axis is y. So fill this. I started with 10. Fill this. After 10, increment 10 by 1. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Can I fill this also similarly? No, I'm not sure. Why I'm not sure? Because I don't know. In some cases, x is getting incremented. So if I look into this post, I got x is 11 here. But y is also incremented. If I go to this pixel, x is same as the previous value, but y got incremented. Here also, x is not incremented, but y got incremented. So for solving these, we want what? Decision variables. So for this, Bresenham's line drawing algorithm we can use. So now, we got dx dy. How do we use a decision variable? So first formula is, deriving axis is y. Initially, find the decision variable value. How do you find? 2 delta x minus delta y. So what do we get? 2 into 2 minus 5. So what we got? Minus 1. So our decision variable for the first value or initial decision variable is minus 1. What do we understand by this minus 1? If the decision variable is minus 1, what does it tell? Keep the x value as it is. Don't increment it. So what did we do? Continue x as it is. Previous x was 10. Keep x as 10 itself. But what about y? This wave already filled. We know deriving axis is y. So it got incremented always by 1. Now once we get this value, I told you this formula is applicable only for the first iteration, initial decision variable value. From the next iteration onwards, it will change. Okay. Okay, what is that? So if based on this value, we will take the other formulas, right? So if you go up to this previous table, I told you. See, if initial is 0, you substitute this formula, right? If it is greater than or equal to 0, we substitute this formula. This I hope you are clear with. Okay. So we got less than 0. So use the first formula. So this is the formula pk plus 2 dx. So what we got now? We got 3 here. So we got 3. Is it greater than 0? Yes. Positive greater than 0. What did we do? What are we supposed to do now? Increment x by 1. So what we got next pixel is 11, 12. So in the diagram, it might look like it may not be very appropriate because I have not used proper scales to draw this line. So just a reference model. So but actually, if you give the coordinates like this, 10, 10 and 12, 15. So first pixel will pass through 10, 10, next 10, 11. So the third will be 11, 12. That's how it should be. Okay. Okay, so this is done. 11 comma 12 is done. Okay, so next location. So what we got here, the pk value we got as what? Minus 3. So if it is negative, we have to use two set of formulas. Remember, this you have to remember. Okay, if pk is negative, I have to use which formula? Pk plus 2 into dx. So pk plus 2 into dx. What is pk? The previous iteration value, that's it, okay. So, minus 3 plus 2 into 2. So, what we got now? Positive value, 1. So, what does it indicate? If it is greater than 0, increment x by 1. So, previous was 11, 13. When you come here, increment x by 1, make it 12, 14. So, this continues like this, okay. So, I got pk as positive greater than 0, so if it is greater than 0, again I have to use this formula pk plus 2 delta x minus 2 delta y. Now you can stop your iteration here. Do we have to continue further? No, we don't have to continue further. Why do we don't have to continue? Because I already told 10, 10, 12, 15 is already filled for us. We were supposed to find these four values. Did we finish finding all these four values? Yes, we are finished. Then we have reached all. We plot the location for all the pixels, so we can stop the process. Okay. Now, from this problem, we can understand one thing. See, what is that is, whenever the deriving axis is y-axis, the number of iterations to be computed is how much? How many, what was the dy value? We got what? 5, right? How many steps did we take to find the pixels? 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it dy minus 1? Yes, 5 minus 1 is 4. So, given these two endpoints, that is 10, 10 and 12, 15, in between how many values we need to find is 4. So, 4 iterations, if you find the decision variable and take a decision, your work is done. Okay. Now, I'll take another example here. Slope is positive, but what it is? Less than 1.0. What is the meaning? So, we'll see how does this problem look like. So, I have one coordinate lying at what? 2, 1. My one endpoint is 2, 1. That you can fill here. Next is what? 8, 3. That also you can fill here. No problem. Find dx. What is dx? dx2 - x1. 8 - 2 = 6. Find dy. What is dy? y2 - y1. 3 - 1 = 2. So, among these two, dx and dy, which is greater? Dx is greater. What does it mean? Deriving axis is x-axis. What is the meaning of deriving axis is x-axis? X gets incremented by 1 always. Okay. Now, what we are supposed to do then? We want to find the value of y. We are not sure whether y will always get incremented by 1. So, we should take the help of decision variable and take a decision. Okay. So, as I told you, we know 2, 1, 8, 3. Deriving axis x. Keep this x incremented by 1. So, we will get 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Done. 8 is already done. Okay. Now, I don't know whether I started at 2, 1, whether I should continue at 3, 1 or I should go to 3, 2. These are the two things. So, we will come take the help of decision variable now. Calculate. What is that? 2 dy - dx. So, what do we get? -2. So, if decision variable is negative, what does it indicate? Continue the previous value. So, I will keep y as it is. Okay, first iteration is over. Now, calculate this using the previous pk value, pk plus 2 into dy. Why did we take pk plus 2 into dy? Because our initial value is negative. If it was positive, then we should use this formula. Okay, pk plus 2 dy minus 2 dx. But since it was negative, we are choosing this formula. This you should make sure. Okay. So, minus 2 plus 2 into 2 into 2, we got what? 2. So, it is positive. Is it greater than 0? Yes. So, what we have to do for the next step? Increment by 1. 4, 2. See here, line is passing at 4, 2. Correct, no? So, again, I know 5, but I am not sure about this. Whether I have to go plot the next pixel at 5, 2 or 5, 3. What I will do? Again, take decision variable. So, what was the previous value? What we got here? Plus 2 we had got for this step, right? So, now pk was greater than 0. Use this formula. Find out what we get? Minus 6. Minus 6 means what? Continue previous y. So, here previous y only I am continuing. Again, pk is less than 0. Again, substitute and find the value. So, if it is less than 0, we are supposed to use this formula. Use that formula and find. I got what? Minus 2. So, minus 2 means again continue the previous y. So, look here. Y didn't change for 3 iterations. Still it is same. So, again we got minus 2. So, it is less than 0. Use this formula. I got plus 2. What does plus 2 mean? You are supposed to change the y value, increment by 1. Don't use the previous y value. So, I got 7, 3. So, did we reach the end of the loop? Yes. This location already I know. I don't have to repeat this. So, again if you observe here, how many iterations did we take? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. What was our dx value here? 6. How many iterations we took? 5. So, can we come to a conclusion that if x is a decision deriving axis, then there are dx minus 1 iteration to reach the final point. It means our loop should repeat how many times? Dx minus 1 times. If y was deriving axis, sorry, here, yeah, we will take the reverse, right? Dy minus 1 times iterations. That's how we are going to solve. So now the other, so we have seen all four cases. Case 1, case 2 don't require any decision variables, but case 3 and case 4 did require. There are two more cases, case 5 and case 6, but I will tell you it's very simple. There is no change at all. Till here will be same, that is find the deriving axis, everything, but only problem or the change in these two cases are either dx is negative or what, dy is negative. That means your slope is having negative value. So what is the change you have to do is nothing. Just if it is negative, instead of incrementing the y value, you will have to what, decrement the y value. Why here? See, I computed dx, it is 4, dy is minus 6. Among these two, which is greater? See, just take the mod value, okay? Don't check the sign. So, some students might get just think, oh, dy is minus 6, dx is 4. So, 6 minus 6 is actually less than 4. Then, how can we say deriving axis is y-axis? I told you, don't consider the sign, just take the value only, okay? That's how we are going to decide on the deriving axis, okay? So if you don't take the sign, dy is definitely greater, right? 6 is greater than 4. So deriving axis is y. So what is the first point here? 2, 8. This we know. What is the last point? We know it is 6, 2. So deriving axis is y means what we are supposed to do. Now y will always get what, incremented or decremented by 1. Now, are we supposed to increment or decrement the value? How do we take a decision? Check the sign of dy now. If dy is negative, decrement y by 1. Rest of the things will remain the same. No change in the formulas of what, decision variables. It will work same as the previous step. And again, you observe here, we had dy is 6 and we took how much? 5 iterations to reach from the given 2 endpoints. So that is again dy minus 1 iterations only. Same way, the last case is nothing but deriving axis would be what? X axis. I think I have not included the screenshot here, sorry. But deriving axis is x axis, but what might happen is dx is negative. So what will you do in that case? No change, same as the previous one. So instead of, so suppose if I had given here x was very 9, 2 and here x was 4, 2. So obviously you will get dx negative, right? So 9, 2 if I start, then I have to start decrementing x. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 2, 3, 2. Then find the value of y, right? That's all about this what? Resonance line drawing algorithm. So I hope I made you people clear how to write this so formulas for decision variable and how you can take a decision among the two neighboring pixels, okay? Now if we are our intention is to write the code for Bresenham's line drawing algorithm, so let's go to that part, okay? So I will just teach you how we can write it. So I'll open a LibreOffice editor file, new text document, okay. So now I want to just tell you how to write the code for Bresenham's. So I'll write the function name as what, word Bresenham's, since the name of the algorithm is Bresenham's. Then we want two endpoints of the line, so I'll take float x1 and what, float y1. Then we will take what, float x2 and float y2. Why did we take these four variables? Yeah, because every line has two endpoints and every endpoint has two coordinates. Yes. What did we do while solving the problem? We know the endpoints. Now we'll calculate what is dx value. What is dx? How do we compute? X2 minus x1, right? Next, what we'll do? We'll compute dy is what? y2 minus y1. Yes. Right. Now, once we get these two values, what did we do? We computed which is greater among those. So, how did we write? If what? I told don't consider the sign here to check the deriving axis. So, we can use f absolute value. So, absolute of what? Dy. That means I am ignoring the sign here. Is greater than absolute of what? Dx. What do we understand by this? If dy is greater than dx, I'll write here our deriving what axis is which arm? Y axis. What do we understand that deriving axis is y axis? Y is always getting incremented by 1. So what I'll write? I'll take a variable y increment is equal to, whether it is, it could be what, plus or minus 1, we don't know. How do we decide whether y increments plus or minus 1? Again, we need to check if what dy is greater than 0, that means y increment is how much? Plus 1. Oh, you can ignore this line. Else, what is y increment we are going to take? It will be what? Minus 1. Now, did we declare all these variables? No. So, we will use all these variables here. Flow to dx, dy. Then what we want? X increment, y increment. You can take int. So, I will take int. X increment is equal to, comma y increment integer. Okay, I'll take this too. Okay, done. Now, once we did experiment, so if deriving axis is y axis, we wrote the formula. What if this condition fails? Dy is greater than dx fails. So, it is false here, then it comes to the else part. So, what are we supposed to do then? Deriving axis is y axis, obviously. So, what we are supposed to do? So, we will have to increment x by 1. So, I will just copy this and paste it here. Does it work? No. What I have to do? I have to change to dx, right? So, x increment is 1. Otherwise, x increment is minus 1. Okay. So, this much is done. Next, what we will do? Do we know the first point? Yes. What is that? X1, y1. Is it given? So, we will call the function called plot point. Where is first coordinate? X1, y1. Why are we plotting this? It is not plotted. It will plot it first. Right. There is no ambiguity here. Okay. Then, what we are supposed to do? We got decision. We have used deriving axis. We set the x increment as y increment, everything. Now, what we are supposed to do? We should proceed further, right? How do we proceed further? Okay, we know the deriving axis. So, if deriving axis is y axis, we know y is always getting incremented by 1. So, then what we are supposed to do? We should find the value for x. How do we find the value? We should take help of Bresenham's code. So, from here, we will actually start Bresenham's code. So, I will write this. So, if deriving axis is y axis, so again, I will check this condition here. Or we will, if absolute of dy is greater than bs of what dx, that means deriving axis y axis, go back and check out the formula. How do we find the initial floating point value? So, how do we find out? So, here we have the formula, right? What is that formula we have written? So, here we have, I'll keep this reference table. So, deriving axis y axis, what is it? 2dx minus dy. So, what is pk for me? For the first iteration, pk is 2 into dx minus dy. Right? We got this. Okay, I got this pk value. What am I supposed to do? I should make a decision. Okay, what is that? If pk is what? Greater than 0. What am I supposed to do now? go back to this slide and just check out. Okay, if the decision variable value is greater than or equal to 0, what are we supposed to do? X is equal to x plus 1. If it is not, then continue x as same. So we'll come back here and write pk is greater than or equal to 0. What we'll write? X is equal to what? X plus 1. Okay. Else, what we will write? X is equal to x only. No need of changing. Okay. Now you might have some doubts about this. I'll solve it. Wait. Okay. So we got this. If the deriving axis is y-axis, we calculated the initial pk value. Based on that, we wrote x is x plus 1 and x or limit. What about y value? Deriving axis is y-axis. So always y will be equal to what? Y plus 1. Irrespective of these two cases, we will write y is equal to what? Y plus 1. Though you don't have to make any choice here. Right? Okay. Now, how many times should we repeat this continuously checking process? Is this sufficient? I will do it once and is it over? Why did we do all these things? We want to reach from where to where? From x1 to where I am supposed to reach, x1, y1, I knew, I plotted it. From where to where I have to go? X1, y1 to x2, y2. So I have to keep checking this process. How many times? I told you while explaining here, it through this iterations, when I reach from one endpoint to the other, I need how many iterations? How many times we have to repeat? D delta y minus 1 times I want to reach from first endpoint to another. How do I repeat this process? So this should be repeated. Correct? The steps should be repeated. How do I repeat it? I'll put this in a for loop. For I equal to 1, I less than or equal to how much? Deriving axis is what? Y axis. Dy minus 1 times I should repeat I plus plus. What I have to repeat? This whole process from here till here. Okay, I'll repeat this process from here to here. What am I supposed to do actually? I plotted the first point x1, y1. So, what about the other values? I should keep plotting that point, right? So, plot point. Where are my points now? First point I knew. What are the new points I have taken in x and y? So, plot what? X, y. I hope you understood the logic. I'm just writing in front of you. Repeat this process. Plot point x, y. How many times? Dy minus y times. Why dy minus y times? Because deriving axis is y axis. Are we done with the code? No, not yet. What is that? What we have missed? The next iteration we have to compute pk value again, right? If pk is greater than or equal to 0. So, okay, first time pk, this is only the initial decision variable. Initial decision variable only. For the next iterations and all, can I use this pk? No. So, first time it will use this. So, once I get pk is greater than 0, I should recompute the pk for the next iterations. What is the formula for pk? If it is greater than 0, pk plus 2dx minus 2dy. So, this I have to write. Where I have to write here? Pk is equal to pk plus 2, I don't, dx minus dy. What if pk was not greater than or equal to 0? If pk was greater than 0, we are using this formula. If it is less than 0, pk plus 2 dx. Pk is equal to pk plus 2 into dx. So, are we done with this? Does this look simple? I've just written the code. It's very simple. Do you think we can improvise this code? Yes, of course. To some extent, we can improvise this code. Now, you'll get some errors for sure in this. What is that? I told x is equal to x only. What was our x here actually? We don't know what is x. So, first when we start, x should be set to what? x1. So, you can do that inside this. Instead, I'll write x is equal to x1 so that otherwise you might get what is x is equal to x plus 1 or x is equal to x, that error you will get. So, if you observe one more thing, see in both, if also y is getting incremented by 1, else y is also, here also y is getting incremented by 1. So, do I have to write twice? You can avoid writing it twice because irrespective of these conditions, y is always getting incremented by 1. So, I can write here just what? Y is equal to y plus 1. Okay. So, are we done with Bresenham's code? No, we missed something. What is that? What is that we have missed? We wrote for if deriving axis is what here? Deriving axis is which axis? Y axis only. What if it is x axis? What are we supposed to do? If this condition fails, that indicates that this code should not work. Obviously, we should come to the else part and what? We should write the other way around. What is that other way around? We should deriving axis is which axis then? Deriving axis is actually our x axis. So, what is the meaning of deriving axis is x axis? Y is equal to y1 will set in the beginning. So, that means tk value should be changed here. What is the meaning of that? 2 into what? Instead of x we should write y, instead of y we should write x. 2 dy minus dx. Then what we have to do? How many times this loop has to repeat? Yeah, dx minus 1 time. So, I'll just copy the same thing as it is from here to here because it is one and the same. It is same, but only thing is what? Instead of x, we have to write y. That's all, right? Deriving is x axis. So, here instead of writing dy minus 1, what we are supposed to write? Dx minus 1. Okay. Here instead of writing x is equal to x plus 1, we should write what? Y is equal to y plus 1 because y value we have to take a decision here. And instead of writing 2dx, we should write dy. Instead of writing 2dy, we should write dx here. And x is equal to x, no. We have to change this to y is equal to y only. Then here also we should change it to dy. Okay. What about x? X will always get incremented by 1 because deriving x is 1. So have we done with the Bresenham's code? Yes, we have done with it. Okay. So finished if, else, everything, I hope. Then we've missed one thing. What is that we have missed? Nothing, but we started plotting the pixels from what? X1, Y1. We reached till dy minus 1 iterations. That means we have missed out the last point. So, where is the last point we have to plot? Plot point at what? X2, comma what? Y2. This is what we have to do. Then finish the Bresenham's algorithm. This is done. End of Bresenham's. This is simple. Okay. Now, if you want, I'll write the code for plot point. What have we passed for plot point? 2 endpoints. So, I'll take float x comma float y here. Okay. Then, how do we plot the point? I think all these things we would be knowing. GL underscore points
GL vertex 2F. Where are our points? X comma Y. GL end, right? Sorry, here made a mistake. Okay, sorry.
Then close this code. Now you can set the color if you want. Here, just GL. GL color 3F. I want in red color 1000 RGB values. Okay, then if you want, you can change the point size. All those things I think you will be knowing, right? So this is how we can write the Bresnahan's line drawing algorithm. So there is nothing much, but only you have to remember the formulas. If you know the formulas, at least one formula if you can remember, you know the logic, then definitely you can write the code. I'll just show how we can execute this. I have already written the code recently, so I'll just execute it and show you. So I'll enter the endpoints. So I'll take x 10, y 1 12, 15 and say 45, something like that. Let's see we got a line. So you have to check the demonstration for all the 6 different cases. I think you can do this. Okay, any doubts you can